Welcome back. Our next guest was part of Louis Walsh's six-piece boy band Hometown and broke hearts nationwide when they went their separate ways 4 years ago.
Since then, he's had major success, reaching the semi-finals in Dancing with the Stars, and now he's returning to Panto in Jack and the Beanstalk at the University Concert Hall, which you'll be able to enjoy from the comfort of your own home. And Dale Cronin joins us on the line this morning. Good morning to you, Dale.
This
sounds brilliant. You're going to be able to enjoy the Panto from the comfort of your own home. Tell us all.
Yeah, so Panto is coming back this year, which is absolutely amazing because obviously with everything going on, people didn't think it was actually going to come back. But yeah, we're in the middle of rehearsals at the minute and it's going to be streamed online, so you can buy it online. Tickets are available now and you can stream it as many times as you want from the 26th of December to the 31st of December. So I think they're like €15 a ticket and you can watch it as many times as you want. So to me, that's an absolute bargain. And why wouldn't you do it? Especially from the comfort of your own home. You don't have to get dolled up. You can sit there in your pajamas, eat away. Not a bother to you.
Happy days. That. And you're no stranger to Panto, Dale, because we were talking before we came on air. I had the pleasure of directing you 6 years ago, was it, as part of Hometown?
Six.
In the Olympia Panto.
Yeah.
And I remember you guys coming in, and it was like the Beatles coming into the room.
Really?
All the young ones were all delighted.
Yeah.
That was a crazy time for you. Take us back to that period 6-7 years ago when Hometown was put together, Dale. First of all, how was it put together? And then what was that 2 years like as part of that group?
Yeah, it was crazy. Like, we all held auditions in the Button Factory and then in the Academy for like 5-6 months. And there was like over 1,000 lads. It got whittled down. And then eventually you picked the six. And yeah, it was just a whirlwind 2 years, just like touring, making music, doing gigs, meeting fans. And it was crazy. Like, I used to like, there was a running thing that I tweeted one day saying I love Pringles. And every time we go somewhere, fans would come up and give me boxes of Pringles.
Yeah.
Hence why I'm now like, but like, I still let them. I was like, bring them on, like salt and vinegar, bring us all the way. But it was brilliant. It was a whirlwind experience, and I'd happily do it again in a heartbeat. Like, it was a brilliant, brilliant time, and we all loved it. We all still talk, and we have our WhatsApp group going, and we're constantly all talking and stuff. But yeah, it was crazy. And obviously getting to work with one of the biggest names in the music industry, Louis Walsh, when he comes knocking on your door, you don't say no. So yeah, it was crazy time.
And even though you guys went your separate ways, as sad and all as it was, it's still a brilliant opportunity for you to take on your own project. So what has been your favourite role to date from everything that you've done?
Oh, that's a tough one. That's a really tough one. Because obviously, since Hometown, I've had Dancing with the Stars, I have my own dance academy, and then this is my fourth Panto in UCH in Limerick. And I think I am really loving it this year because it's a different experience. But I think my favorite thing was last year when I played Aladdin in the Panto. It was just like, it was amazing. And it was like really, like it was just a crazy time. And I think I left the stage maybe twice throughout the whole thing. And I remember it's just like, the sweat would be coming through me, even though as you can see, I'm wearing half nothing as it is. Like, but it was just, it was a brilliant, brilliant time. But yeah, Hometown really helped my career as such, and it was just a great time.
It must have been so weird though last year, because even chatting to Simon at the moment directing Pantomime, it's just so tricky when you're keeping 2 metres apart from everyone. And the joy of Pantomime is that there's a gang of people on stage and it's a very tactile event to watch and take part in. So how did you navigate all of the restrictions in place this time around?
Yeah, well, so for us, we were obviously beforehand, we were kind of like taking care of like where we were going and things like that, and we've actually been tested a load of times that like we've been tested so many times that I absolutely hated it. Oh my god. But yeah, so we've been tested and we're currently all isolating together in a Panto bubble. Like, our Panto bubble, it's like a Big Brother house down here. Like, we can't go anywhere, we're not allowed to go to the shops, and we're not allowed to do anything. We're only allowed to see, I think there's like what, 12 of us in the cast or something, and that's it. We're only allowed to see the 12 of us, and we haven't killed each other yet. Oh god. But it has been amazing. And like, there's a lot of new people to the cast this year, so I'm actually not new anymore. I'm like the old person now. Like, it's weird because before I was always the new person. But it's a great cast and we're all having so much fun, and it's brilliant.
One of the things I remember about working with you, Dale, was when you did that Panto 6 years ago, was that you can dance. And I thought, boy, you can dance, because they had you doing cartwheels, etc., in the Panto. You remember those flips and all that? But then I remember when you went on to Dancing with the Stars, it was no surprise. Because that must have been like a busman's holiday for you. You really looked as if you enjoyed that whole competition, that whole process.
Oh, that to me was the best thing ever. Like, because I have trained in dancing, but I haven't trained in ballroom and Latin and quick step and jiving and all that. But for me, it was the best thing ever, because I was getting paid to dance every day. And like, that's every dancer's dream. Like, do you know what I mean? Like, there's Curtis Pritchard, who was now like one of the most famous people in the world now because he did Love Island. And there was me meeting him, and he was like, "Can I get a picture of you for my Instagram?" And now I would be like, "Curtis, can I get a picture of you for my Instagram?" But yeah, it was a brilliant, brilliant time. And yeah, no, I actually remember in the Olympia Panto, I did the flip up. I ran up the wall and did a backflip.
I remember
holding the wall. And like, I don't think I actually told anyone that. And like, yeah, I just outed myself on telly now.
Yeah,
like,
well, it's fine. I'm heading there this afternoon. I'll bring in some polyfill. It'll be fine.
You'll have to. Yeah.
You were very busy in lockdown because you also started a podcast a few months ago as well. Why did you start the podcast, and what's involved in the making of the podcast? Does it take a lot of time in terms of the edit?
Yeah, it actually, I have it down to a fine art now where I know how to edit it and it doesn't take me that long. But at the start, I think it took me like 4 hours to edit the first episode, and I wasn't even editing anything. It was just cutting it. And because I'm no way techie, like I can't, like, even to work this Skype, I was like...
We did see that.
And like, I was like, I have nothing else to do. My dance school is closed. I was like, look, I'll use this as kind of like my, just to keep me busy. And like, I do like... kind of, it's nearly like radio. So like, I was like, look, I'll use this as a platform to like maybe get a job in radio if anybody's listening, like, you know, or 2FM or Park, you know. So yeah, it was just something great. And I get to interview people, and that's the best thing about it, is I get to talk to people that I would not normally talk to, and like interview them and ask them about their life and like how they got into things. So like, they're giving advice to me, and then I'm able to give that advice to people listening on, like, especially like on auditions and how they work and like how you get into this career path and stuff. So it is a great thing for me and a great thing for people out there that I'm kind of giving like a business and a service to them that they can get advice from it.
Well, listen, pass on our best to the entire cast and crew down there. They're a great gang down in Limerick. I hope the show will be a huge success. It always is. Good to talk to you, my friend. Keep up the good work and continued success, buddy.
Brilliant. Thank you very much. Thank you so much for having me on. I really appreciate
Thanks,
it.
And Dale. Yeah, a pleasure. Have a lovely Christmas.
sell, kiddo. Thanks, Dale. Yep. Now, you can catch Dale in the online production of Jack and the Beanstalk from December 26th to the 31st. Head over to uch.ie for more information.